Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for February the 5th of 2020, well, it is titled Lunar Eclipse Perspectives. So what do we see here? Well, this is a set of images, and in fact, 7 images taken during the total lunar eclipse of last year. Now, as we've talked about in previous images, there are no lunar eclipses, total lunar eclipses this year, although there will be several partial or penumbral eclipses. However, this eclipse from last year was very interesting in that a few things happened. First of all, we got this nice image that I'll talk about. But in addition, if you see on each of these images, there is a labeling that says L1-21J. That was actually a meteorite impact on the moon that happened to occur during the lunar eclipse. And it helps us to time these images. We know exactly when they were taken because of that, because they were taken at the time of that impact, which takes place, of course, very quickly. So able to put them all together. Now, if you notice how they're placed on the image is not just a random placing. This is actually a result of what we call parallax. Now, parallax is the apparent motion of a closer object relative to more distant objects. So one common way to look at this is to hold your arm out at arm's length with your finger up. And as you blink your eyes back and forth between the left eye and the right eye, you will see your finger appear to jump relative to more distant objects. Your finger isn't changing. Nothing else is changing except for the perspective with which you are looking. When you're looking at each eye is in a slightly different position. Now, that doesn't work for the moon with your eyes because the moon is way too far away and you're not going to be able to see that. However, if you look from different positions on the Earth, you will be able to see that then. And that's what we're seeing here. If you look at all of the little stars labeled, a lot of BD, HD numbers scattered around there are actually stars. So all of these images have been lined up with those stars to be able to get everything the same. And then the positioning of the moon, where did the moon fall? And we can see that it was quite a different position in Germany than it was in the Georgia in the United States. So very different positioning. In fact, there they didn't even overlap. However, when you look at closer areas like Germany and Austria and the Czech Republic, it just looks like almost one moon there. There's only slight differences because they are relatively close together. So depending on the exact positioning of where you are on the Earth, the moon will be in a slightly different position in the sky. Now, it's not very far away. The size of the moon is about a half of a degree. So we're only moving by about a couple of moon diameters at the most extreme here. But parallax is very important to astronomers because this same process is what we use to measure distances to stars. We look for stars shifting, not at different points on the Earth observing, just like we can't use blinking our eyes to measure the parallax of the moon. We can't use different positions on the Earth to measure the parallax of the stars. That is because they are too far away. However, we can look at their positions 6 months apart. And that what we're using there is the motion of the Earth in its orbit from one side of its orbit to the other. And that would be about 180 million miles or about 300 million kilometers in difference. So much, much bigger than we could possibly get on the Earth. Even then, it can be difficult, but we are now measuring distances with new satellites to many millions and millions of stars using the same type of method that we are seeing in the image here today. In this case, we're looking at the moon, but this same process can carry on to other objects that we use as well to help us to determine distances in astronomy. So that was our picture of the day for February the 5th of 2020. It was titled Lunar Eclipse Perspectives. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.